history is of that of the Prophet Abraham, who exterminated the culture of homicide for the pleasing of the mighty forces. It seems like yesterday that my senior lawyers, colleagues, and mentors were smiling, giggling, chatting away, and on one August morning, it was business as usual at the district court of Quetta. This business was, however, disrupted in the ugliest way imaginable. The morning of 8 August 2016 brought dramatic change in my life. On that day, 56 lawyers of Balochistan Bar Council and Balochistan Bar Association got killed in an instant in a suicide attack. Things have changed, and it seems now as if no one left. Neither an astute interpreter of the statute nor the defender of human rights. The terrorists virtually wiped out an entire generation of educated people of Balochistan. The vices for the recovery of the missing persons and the flag barrier of the rule of law have been silenced forever. Funnily, many people say, "You are a Hazara. Why you are mourning on Pashtuns and Baloch?" They are probably right. And they are thinking that in a country like ours, people are also so divided that when even we lost the ability of understand each other's pain. Born in Balochistan province of Pakistan, I came from the frequently victimized ethnic minority group of province, the Hazaras. I'm the first female lawyer from my community and the first practicing with the law firm. It was very difficult. It was very difficult to pursue a career in law given the deep-rooted patriarchal and tribal capitalist environment around me, but I managed to beat the odds to get here. It started up with the theory and practice of human rights. I always failed to understand that our society set up where people wait for disaster to reach their doorstep, a step after reacting. Not learning to effect the change before the change affect them. At a very early age, I had joined Youth for International Socialism, dreaming of a classless society and equality for all. In a tribal society, being a socialist girl means a characterless woman. Challenging the perverted social norms, but I proved it wrong at every stage. Sometimes abdicating the very human desires that every person has. It was a beautiful phase of our life. There were no ethnic and religious prejudices. And I still believe there is none in ordinary members of our community. Some elements for their own designs may line up merciful religion and polarize the communities. They divided Balochistan. I united them. While risking my life and career, my reputation and security, I am proud that I stood firm for whatever I decided to stand. Today I came here to speak of good things. The lighter side of a young girl's life, a girl who loves to put on a purple and red lipstick, knowing the men don't have the monopoly of it yet. The hardcore feminist, someone called me feminazi, is not a simple way we think. I chose the hard form of feminism.
Streets and attempt to give a voice to those who have never heard it.
It is not about feminism, but about giving voice for their dignity back. I chose to stand against oppressing powers, the power which are patriarchal in attitude, and try to tell them that the concept of a state based on equality, distribution of power, and tolerance is the only concept that people would welcome. I speak here today to many a sister and mother while several mother and sisters are sitting at Quetta Press Club looking for their loved ones.
they haven't seen for many years. The loved ones, they have been disappeared. Yet, yes, I'm a different kind of feminist. I'm a bad feminist. I don't shy away. I don't shy away from questioning the suppression of women
under the guise of culture, turning women into objects under the pretense of freedom and empowerment.
I believe it is through law that an effective and justice social contract can be realized, where deprived, underserved, and victimized people can be held, and equal rights and opportunities can be obtained peacefully and democratically. In addition to being a lawyer, I'm also a political activist, raising voice for democratic and constitutional rights of women and other women oppressed groups. The situation of women rights in Pakistan is dismal. Being a women rights defender, I provide free legal aid and counseling to poverty affected women on issues that include honor killing, domestic violence, marriage dispute, sexual harassment, and property rights.
The story that I call History of the Pen and Graveden start on 8th of August 2016
with the loss of so many friends. I had previously lost close relatives of mine. Two of my uncles, along with their teen sons, were gunned down in broad daylight in the year 2010. Needlessly to say, nobody has been arrested for their murder. A good friend who was a student of IBA gunned down in the city of Quetta. Around 3,000 people have been killed and they never got justice. These incidents have shaken me in the core. On 28th of April last year, shortly after my return from taking part in the Stockholm Gender Equality Forum in Sweden, I was still struggling with the jet lag when I was told two Hazaras had been brutally butchered on the streets of Quetta. The scream of the little boy involved me in the incident shook me up and made me rush to Quetta Press Club. I decided to make a decisive protest and sit on hunger strike till death. My demand, however, peculiar. Coming from a Democrat who was to have the chief of army staff come and visit the camp, it was the moment I decided that I will not return back without achieving anything, because the 3,000 of my community members had lost their lives for no reason. In my endeavor, I managed to unite the people of Balochistan as one voice, and after the fifth day of hunger strike, the Chief of Army Staff of Pakistan had visited it. Ever since my hunger strike, our people are living in relative peace without any fear of being killed on the grounds of their faith and ethnicity. It was all of the act of conscience and the support of all local Pashtun, Baloch, Christian, Hindu, Punjabis, and Hazaras helped me achieve what I had set out to do. With the support of the people, I would have been nothing but a lone voice. I am indebted till my last breath. I don't know what politics says, but for me, holding each other's hand is what matters. As Dr. Chigavera says that we cannot be sure of having something to live for unless we are willing to die for it. Chigavera said it about his own struggle, but to me it speaks of my belief in the greater man's word. Many will call me an adventurer, and that I am. Only one of the different sort, one of those who risk his skin to prove his platitude.
People thought after my hunger strike and reaching to my demands fulfilled, I will go silent. But no, that is not likely to happen.
I still live in Quetta city, running about in rickshaw. With little money as any other youth of my generation, and you can still see me at Quetta Press Club, standing with everyone who questions injustice. I'm part of you. Thank you.